Hey, everybody. Thank you for joining our podcast, Moms on the Move. I'm Jen Wills.
And I'm Ashley Steigerwald.
We have two guests with us today, Caroline Staley and Sarah Rainer Painter, who is my dear friend, Sarah Painter. So we are here to talk about small businesses and the pop-up shop and just women entrepreneurs. So thank you for coming.
Thanks for having us.
I know. This is so fun. We found out that you guys know each other.
Well, we have a
common link.
Yeah. Common link from scouting. Bill Mulligan, shout out. Hey, Bill Mulligan, what's up?
So I hope if you are watching, you can see this beautiful piece of artwork behind us. It's gorgeous. So you started selling with Sarah your artwork. You're based out of
Charleston, South Carolina.
Okay. But you have connections to Greenville.
I grew up in Greenville.
Okay.
Yes.
So, yeah, I mean, I've been seeing your stuff, but last night we went to your pop-up.
Yep.
So you have a new store.
Yep.
Are we allowed to call it that?
Yeah, we're calling it
a
showroom. It's a shop where we'll have events, we'll have appointment times, we'll have, I mean, it's sort of like whatever we decide from time to time.
So you are the owner and founder of Loggerhead Apparel.
Yes. Yes.
And so, local goods.
And local goods, yes.
Yes.
Which is sort of an evolution of our brand that my husband Zach and I created over 10 years ago now.
Is it really?
Yeah, I know.
Oh, that is so crazy.
Because our son is 9 and a half, and he was born shortly after we started.
Wow.
So it's been a busy 10 years.
Yeah.
Kind of flew by.
So tell us about.
Yeah, so we created Loggerhead because there was just this shortage in Greenville, South Carolina, which used to be textile center of the world, or of the U.S., there was a shortage of made-in-U.S. clothing. Mm-hmm. I mean, my husband, Zach, always said, I have 20 different polo shirts and golf shirts in my closet, and not one of them is made in the U.S. Actually, one of them was made in the U.S., Burberry, not even a U.S. company. And it was so frustrating because he grew up in Spartanburg, which is like textile mill, grew up in a mill village. His grandparents worked in textile mills. And he always had that like sense of American-made pride. You know, I'm going to buy these American-made paper towels and cars and tires. But why can't we find clothing made here locally or even in the U.S.? And when we started kind of going down that road of, are there still people doing it? There were.
Yeah.
They were doing more like technical items like uniforms and safety jackets and stuff like that. But the vendor that we first partnered with to make our polo shirts in South Carolina used to make Ralph Lauren polos.
Mm-hmm.
So before all that business went overseas, and you know, we're small. We started small. We're still small. That's kind of the way that we like it.
Yeah.
And we're able to do what we want to do and keep it the way we wanted to create it. So that's one part of our mission. The other part is that we give a portion of our sales to sea turtle conservation. So we made the parallel between the endangered sea turtle and the endangered American textile industry.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm from the Charleston area, and that was sort of my background of conservation-minded.
Yeah.
And there are a lot of conservation organizations down there who need the support. So, yeah, that's what we do. And then in the past little while, we sort of wanted to evolve our brand and continue supporting locally made products. And so I started partnering with other artists and makers to bring on more goods that I didn't have to create and produce, you know, mass
necklace,
produce.
Earrings.
Yes, yes. Yep. So, so the first person that I kind of partnered up with was Caroline, and we didn't know each other personally, although now we've become friends and we have these like parallel lives, because I'm from Charleston, living here in Greenville, and
Greenville living in Charleston.
Yeah, yeah, and both like three kids. I'm about soon to be three kids.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
We all have three kids. Yeah. That's so funny.
Oh my gosh.
What's your age spreads?
So 9, 6, and
on the way.
On the way.
Okay.
16, 13, and 9.
Oh, you guys are like
15, 11, 9.
Girl.
We have a lot. Yeah. We have a lot to talk about later.
Yeah. Yeah.
And a lot to
Which is why we're here, right? Like we're all moms in this.
Yeah.
So, you know, we've been doing this for quite some time, but you know, it just felt like we wanted to expand our product offering, but I didn't want to continue like just mass producing and taking on all the burden and the, you know, the investment of it. And the more I saw, it actually was just like personal, just like Zach personally wanted to do something, you know, that was made in US. Personally, I wanted to have a place that I could find everything that I like to buy. So I was consuming artwork and jewelry, like handmade jewelry, and, you know, paper goods. And so Loggerhead local goods evolved.
Well, that's our only nice clothes we have is Loggerhead boys. So if you ever see the boys in a collar chart, it is Loggerhead. That's it.
And do you get them into the turtle polos, the turtle shirts, because it's Sully's?
Like, yeah, well, it's usually forced, but that helps because Bennett loves Sully, her 9-year-old.
Yeah.
So if we have photos, that's literally the only time. Otherwise, they wear their fast shirts and their fast
shirts. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That dry fit material. Yeah. It's all they wear. That's it.
I think that's
normal.
That's, that's totally normal.
Yeah.
It's the gym clothes 24/7.
Yeah. I mean, I'm not judging. I mean, as I wear my yoga pants all the time.
All the time.
Right. Yeah.
So talk to me about the paintings.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
What I wanted to hear really was, so Sarah said you were like nervous to put your name at first.
I was.
That's the part of the story I love the most.
I know.
I was. So I studied art at College of Charleston, and I participated in like a little co-op with some other artists and paid like $100 a month to have my art in this space. And I couldn't make enough money to pay that. So it was very intimidating as an artist. And I realized very quickly I would never like make my way in that field. And it was kind of disheartening. But at the same time, it was real world, right? Mm-hmm. So I went on to be a flight attendant. And that's how I supported myself. Met my husband, got married, had kids. And after I had my third child, I felt like, as a mom, really lost. Like, who am I? I need, I'm struggling to figure out, like, who am I anymore? Like, I need something for me.
Something.
I was giving, giving, giving. So I just kind of therapeutically started painting. And then people, so I painted over her crib. And people saw it and would ask me for some pieces. And then I got encouragement from someone to, like, really get my work out there. And I didn't want to put my name on it because I didn't want to have pity buys from friends like, oh, that's really sweet, you know? sure. So my husband always said, if somebody said, well, where's Caroline? What's she doing? And he would say, she's gallivanting somewhere. So I, for some reason, thought it was funny just to sign the paintings Gallivanter.
Mm-hmm.
And I bought a little wall space in a local shop in Mount Pleasant and started a Facebook page and an Instagram page. And funny enough, I sold like 10 pieces off of Facebook immediately, sold nothing at the store. So pulled my stuff from the store and went all Facebook and Instagram, you know, gung ho. And I did it all under the name Gallivanter though, because I was still, you know, still need, I guess I needed the validation that it wasn't just somebody doing it because it was me, that they actually really liked my work.
Yeah.
So hence the name Gallivanter.
I love that. And that's such a common feeling.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Well, we've talked about it just with the podcast. We're like, who are we to have a podcast? Like,
oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So many times.
It was very awkward at first.
Yeah. So awkward.
Yeah.
That's such a better way or a more natural way for a brand to be born than like a, I've participated in like naming sessions for different products and stuff. And, you know.
There's a story behind it.
It's very personal. It's real. Right. Yeah. It's like what you felt.
Well, and it's still, every time somebody buys a painting from me, I'm still like, oh my gosh. Yeah. Like, I guess it's good. I guess it's okay.
It's imposter syndrome.
Yeah. It's the validation and just like the, okay, I'm doing something and my time is well spent. And people like it. So that feels really good to me.
But I thought what you said was interesting is after your kids, it's like the who am I?
Mm-hmm.
And so I like role versus soul. It's like how much of my day am I spending in my role as mom, wife, realtor versus am I doing anything for my soul?
Right.
And I felt like for years I was just role. And it's and even just now starting to figure out taking that, even if it's 10 minutes to do something for the soul for today, outside of the roles that everybody else has, you know, labeled mom, realtor, mm-hmm. you know, wife, that kind of thing. So
right. Well, in the mom role, it's so it's like so consuming, which and it's is. Great.
It's
right.
such but a balancing But you have to have some act. Boundaries, yes. too, though. Yes. You need to feel preserve like you yourself, lose yourself so you can that. Give 100% and feel yep. good about it authentically, too. Mm-hmm.
Preserve so. Yourself so you have something to give.
Right.
Because I think yes. if you just keep emptying yourself out.
Yep.
Yeah. 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 You got to fill that bucket.
That's exactly right. Yeah.
And
yeah.
I feel like it's so good to do it alongside other people who are in the same.
Yep.
situation as you. I mean, you guys are realtors and you're working alongside each other mm-hmm. and yeah. you've now created this Moms on the Move Greenville that is helping other moms and bringing people together. And that's mm-hmm. what I felt. I felt like I was, you know, kind of on an island trying to hawk shirts and, you know, like just sell myself, and which is so uncomfortable. I mean, it's when people ask me about my company, I'm like, oh, it's just this little thing.
Yeah. That you said it too, this little co-op. Yeah. And yeah. I think we as women have a tendency to do that. Like, oh, it's
like,
just
apologize
this,
for it.
It's like, this little yeah. dog thing. So Jen put together yeah. that amazing auction for the cause, and she gets all these vendors, and it's such a great event. And whenever you would ask her about it, she'd be like, it's this little dog thing. And I'm like,
it's not
a little dog thing. Like, you're putting on a legit charity yeah. event, but we have a tendency Aww. To... Because we don't want to put ourselves out there, and it's that fear of rejection.
You don't need boastful
vulnerable.
Either, yeah. because no. you don't, yeah, don't. Want to like right. come yeah. across.
There's a line there, yeah. but I think yeah. it's stepping forward, and it's like that little T-shirt line. Or that it's like, no, like you were making it happen.
It's yeah. hard right. to own it.
It is.
Yeah.
It's very
it
hard. But
is.
What has helped me is to literally work alongside and partner with other people, because right. I love talking about Caroline's art. Right. I love talking about Molly South, who is my ceramic jeweler here in Greenville, who's also an art teacher. And I will boast on her all day long about what she does. And
I think organic cross-pollination yeah. yes. between businesses is yes. kind of the, like, that's worked very well for me.
Yeah.
And mm-hmm. I think, like, moms want to know what that mom's right. doing. And what's that mom doing? What is she like? And
well,
who,
I
like,
think it's
wow.
helpful to see women supporting each other.
Yeah.
For sure. Instead yeah. of breaking each other down.
That's exactly
yes. yeah, exactly. Yeah, exactly.
It's nice.
And
yeah.
I mean, nice community. I found Caroline like on Instagram yeah. and through a local art show, and I literally cold called her. I was like, hey,
I have this little T-shirt line. I see your look.
No, I literally did. And she was like, I've seen you guys at the South Carolina Aquarium. We're members there. And I was like, oh, yeah. Like, and we've like, most of our donations have gone there. Like, we mm-hmm. helped. You know, awesome. Them build their sea turtle hospital. But, like, right. you know,
a big deal.
It's just, you know, but it was like, I love you. Can we be friends? Can we work together? And Caroline was like, yeah, let's do it. Yeah. You know, and that just, that feels good. Yeah. You know, like when you sell a painting, it's validating, right. you know, and to work alongside people. And I'm like, oh, sorry, hang on just a second. I have my kids yelling in the background. Mm-hmm. When I was calling on retail stores in the past, I was terrified of my kids, like, crying in the background or talking yes. in the background. Like, you have
Be
to hide them away.
Mommy's going to murder you after this phone call.
Well, or they were babies. I mean, yeah. we literally created Loggerhead, got married, and had a baby. And so that role versus soul, mm-hmm. I had this role and this thing that we created, and then shift, you're now a full-time mom. And
are you nervous about having the third?
Well, because it's the third and I've been nervous mm-hmm. like for the last 10 years and anxious, I'm kind of like, well, here we go again.
One more.
No more anxiety than usual.
Yeah,
that's right.
So true. We adopted a puppy this past spring and like 2 weeks later found out I was pregnant with this little gal here. And that was quite...
That's a lot.
Yeah. Jen got a couple calls from me. But, you know.
It's like that overwhelm.
Yeah. But then you kind of come down to it and you're like, if I can just stop spinning my wheels and just do it. Like one step in front of the other, one foot in front of the other and just do it. Like stop. And that was something that I heard on one of your early podcasts. It was like, stop overthinking it and just do it.
Mm-hmm.
Analysis paralysis.
Yeah. Yep. Oh my gosh.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah.
That is that me happens. To a T. Yep. Like, yep. I have gone cold on social media for my brands before because I just couldn't, like, during COVID, I was like, I can't even feel the reason or the need to sell clothing at the very beginning of COVID.
I know.
Like, what is this relevance? Yeah. Do you know what? People didn't stop ordering on my website.
Right. Maybe they even ordered more because everybody was just home wearing t-shirts and joggers. Right? T-shirts and joggers.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And you couldn't order stuff from like big boxes that were waiting for stuff from overseas. Mm-hmm. I mean, I was trying to order undies for my little girl from Old Navy and like couldn't get them.
Yeah.
But then the people who like operate small and are still operating small and, you know, don't have to deal with infrastructure and you know, all that, then
I feel like that's like such an important topic though. Like this recently, we kind of talked about this right when you walked in today. There's been like this really intense heaviness lately.
Yeah.
More so, I feel, and like the way who I'm talking to, it just seems like that's the consensus. We send our kids to school and we should feel this like relief, but I think everyone is so stressed out right now.
Yeah, it's like you hold your breath.
And it's the pendulum swinging.
Are they in school? Like, are they not in school?
Not?
Are they going to stay?
Yeah.
And I think before.
And how do we even communicate to them too?
Like, I know. What's the right thing? Right. What does this look like? When is this going to be over?
Yeah.
And then you like are trying to also at the same time like promote real estate, talk about like funny mom things. Is that appropriate?
Yeah. Right. Stuff's going on in the world.
Right.
That's right. There's a lot of serious stuff going on in the world
now. So you're like, do I post about, like, I mean, it's just.
Yeah, sometimes you feel bad posting, like, not about current events, but I try not to for that reason. Because I'm like, maybe this could be an escape for somebody that, like, you know, sometimes I like to live in my bubble.
Yeah.
No. And I know what's going on, and it's hard and it's heavy, but at the same time, we do have to put one foot in front of the next and continue on if we want to survive. I mean, that's just. The way it is. So, like, it's, sometimes I feel irrelevant because I have nothing to add to a lot of the stuff that's going on. I want it to be nice and pretty. Like, can we go back there, please?
I know. I know. Yeah.
But I thought that was the important thing about small businesses, especially during COVID, was the agility that you saw where, you know, everybody's just ordering everything from Amazon and two-day shipping and Instacart. And, you know, it's this fast pace, everything's big box. And even locally, when, you know, the COVID restrictions were first started to be lifted a little bit, you saw those local restaurants and those local vendors really being able to pivot because they weren't bogged down by big processes or shipping from overseas. Like they were just keeping it going. I found that just fantastic, especially with a lot of our local owned restaurants were able to make it through.
And I can't speak for Charleston, but I know in Greenville, we are big. Yes. In supporting, like, local.
Oh, we're big and local, too. Yeah. I feel like it is. Yeah, and it's funny. We're kind of snobs. I love that. I feel like we've got such great food and so many local restaurants that anytime we go out of town and, like, have to eat at a chain, God forbid, we're like, oh, this is awful. Like, we'll go on vacation, and we're like, this is awful. And we're like, we are very spoiled where we live. Yeah. And Greenville's, y'all have a lot of the same restaurants, too, now. I think there's, like, that connection there between Charleston and Greenville. It's a very strong connection. Yeah. So I feel like y'all are very
similar. Where are you selling the most pieces? Charleston?
Yeah, but I ship to California, to Maine, the Bahamas.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. Where else? All over.
What type of art? Like, is it like
a lot of it's coastal? A lot of it's coastal. This is a new kind of style that I'm doing.
Well, there was three last night. Uh-huh. They were all together, and it was women wearing bathing suits.
Right.
But I loved that you had different body types on it.
Right.
Like, I loved it. I was like, this is awesome.
Oh, thank you.
And then the one, there was a bike. Yeah. Riding a bike.
The surfboard.
Surfboard. Then, like, alligator, crabs. I mean, just, it's really pretty stuff.
Oysters.
Like, really. I love lots of blue.
Turtles.
Blue,
right? Turtles.
Yeah. Yeah. I love how Caroline describes that, like, she loves to paint all things salty. And I was like, I love all things salty too.
Yeah. I could be a little salty myself. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
More salty than sweet. That's savory. Yeah. That's what we'll call it.
So who else is in this pop? Is this like a pop-up? You're doing different places? Is this a brick and mortar? Like, tell us.
Well, now, so yes, pop-up has what I've been doing since COVID. Mm-hmm. We used to have a brick and mortar store, and that was where we kind of operated small, where we were shipping and fulfilling out of there. It allowed us to kind of have control over our customer service and then also have, you know, a showroom space. Then COVID, so we didn't have a brick and mortar store then. And so I was doing pop-ups, and then now I have a more permanent showroom. That's what we're going to call it at the moment. Mm-hmm. Until
perfect
I
perfect space.
Until I commit to whatever more I want to commit to. We have an online shop, and I, you know, kind of finally got with the program and updated my website so that I could put one-off original artwork on there and original jewelry and pieces like that, so mm-hmm. that we could, you know, we could sell that anywhere, not just locally. But we've brought in other products that are sort of, they're all locally made, all small batch, original, one of a kind, and loving that people are collaborating with us.
Yeah.
It's been a good thing. So we've got like a baker that we work with. And so that,
well,
yeah, brought some goodies.
I got some of that and it's so good. I actually was like, how do I order that in bulk?
You can.
I can.
I get actually like a porch drop off of the peanut butter bars.
Okay.
On a regular basis.
It was this like delicious power cookie. And I was like, is this going to make me skinny? So I feel like it is.
Well, because it's packed with protein, it's yummy. Mm-hmm. And I think those are baked with butter, as is anything that's baked. But it's packed with like granola and things that are going to fill you up so that you're not going to keep munching through the day. You ate it for breakfast, so mm-hmm. that's your morning start.
And your stomach's not growling. Usually we get to the second episode, and we're sitting next to you, and I hear your stomach growling.
Mm-hmm. Every time. Sorry.
Yeah. Same. It's the baby.
I'm not. That's not me. But that, yeah, honestly, you had some really good stuff. So where can everyone find you?
Yeah, so for the pop-up shops and the local events, we have pages. It's Loggerhead Local Goods. You can find us on Facebook and Instagram. And then everything online, if you're not local to Greenville, you can find on our website, which is loggerheadapparel.com. And we've pulled in a lot of those products. All of Caroline's artwork can be found there. Caroline does commission, so you can get a good idea of, you know, some of the work that she does. And then we tag all of our collaborators and artists in all of our stuff so that you can find their individual pages too.
Yeah.
There's a lot of like custom options, custom artwork, custom stationery. Work with a stationery vendor here locally who is also one of our best friends from Clemson.
Yeah.
And another mom of three, actually.
so many of us.
Just
what is going on here?
I know. It's your fault that, that I'm doing this, down this path again. No. She's a good friend of ours and is doing the balancing act. Mm-hmm. And it's just another great way to cross-pollinate and, you know, support each other, women supporting women. And I mentioned the ceramic artist, Molly South, who has the most gorgeous jewelry and home goods and vases and little dishes. I mean, just anything.
Mm-hmm.
Great price point for gifts at every price point. So it's really fun.
Teacher gifts, Christmas gifts.
I was just thinking that. Teacher gifts. Yep. Yeah.
Yes. People were asking us last night.
Birthday gift.
Yeah. I don't want to like timestamp this, but we are still in August. And people were asking us last night, do you have ornaments out yet? And we were like,
oh yeah,
gosh.
You do the ornaments too.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Every Christmas.
Yeah.
So pretty.
So we'll have them soon.
We will. Yes.
Gotta get working.
Gotta get to work. Now that the kids are in school.
Yeah, I know.
And we're messing around.
I know.
I know. I think I saw something. It was like 100 days till Christmas.
Stop.
Because that's also 100 days until baby comes.
Oh, yeah. Oh, no.
There's a countdown.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
It's still like 95 degrees.
Oh, my God.
I can't even.
I know. Yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah, we're just
doing like
an it.
Oprah's like
favorite thing.
Yes. For Christmas.
Oh, yeah.
Let's do it.
That would be so much fun. You get an ornament. Everybody gets an ornament.
Love this. Yeah. We're doing it.
Nobody's getting a car.
Right. I know.
No.
I actually did that last year. I was like, when we were, you know, selling off some short sleeves tees and moving into long sleeve tees, I was like, you get a t-shirt and you get a t-shirt. Yeah. You know, sale t-shirts.
You have great stuff. Oh, everyone needs to go to your website. Do you have a website or is it Instagram,
I do.
Facebook?
Well, it is mostly Instagram and Facebook driven, which is at Gallavantor, G-A-L-L-A-V-A-N-T-O-R. And the Gallavantor on Facebook. And then I have gallavantorart.com, which is a place where you can go. And it's just kind of more of a placeholder, but you can also submit your name and information, and I'll get back to you if you have questions about anything. Or
And she really does. That's how I cold called her.
Yeah. I do. Yeah, I was in a moment of like, you know what? I need to just say yes.
Yes.
Like, I got to step out there and do something uncomfortable and different. And he called like right when I was going through this yes moment.
If you put that out to the universe. That's right. You put that
energy
out.
That's how she got on the podcast. I was like, ah.
You put it out. You put that energy out and people respond to it.
And said yes. And just say thinking, yes.
Right? That's right. You say yes.
Can't overthink it.
No more
hold
analysis.
Hold your nose and jump.
Yeah, I know.
So true.
Yep. I know.
And it's been great.
It has
I'm
been.
Glad that you called
it's
me.
Fun. Yeah. Because we don't have to do it alone.
I know. It is so much That's easier when you have somebody to help you. And like, it's probably easier for me to talk her company up and easier for her to talk
it's
my
so much
art
easier.
Up, you know?
Yes.
I mean,
yeah.
It's that whole support and knowing that you're not alone.
Yep. Yeah. We've talked about that. Build your tribe.
Yep. Yes. That's so true. You are always supportive of everything. So
same.
Yeah.
Yep. All your boys wearing their turtle
shirts. All the children
need
to wear.
You had on the cute polo dress last night. That
no,
was
I didn't.
Oh, I thought you did.
No, I was the one that was dirty that showed up with like.
You looked great. Now I remember you.
Faking it to make it.
Yeah.
Cute skirt on. You look cute great. Skirt. Now I remember you. Oh, my God.
I was like, she did, though. I was like, wow.
I know.
Yeah.
I
had worked out. Just gone to the gym.
I had been at this.
Big earrings.
Yeah. If you put earrings on.
Yes.
With your hair in a bun. Mm-hmm.
I will say you pull that off because you've done several selfies before where you're like, just finished working out at the gym and you're like perfectly golden and like the
a bun.
The perfect messy bun. Yeah.
It's just because it's a bun. It just like works. And,
but you do a good messy bun.
Some people can do a good messy bun.
I was about to say, I look like it's just.
Well, because your hair's so long probably.
Maybe.
But the other day she did show up to my house and I just have to brag on you.
Oh.
She had my dream.
The bike shorts.
I keep wanting to wear those bike shorts, okay? I just want to be
able to. I've never
uttered
those words before.
The little 5-inch bike shorts.
Dream big.
Yes, dream big, everybody.
She came over and I was like, damn it. I can't pull them off. I have tried.
Yes, you can.
No. But she had them on and I was like, she looked so good.
Thank you.
So good. Yeah, so nice. Anyway.
It
looked great.
I appreciate that. Yeah. Would you want me to wear them for the next podcast?
Please, with the hat. I keep telling her she needs to try a hat.
I wouldn't see it.
She's trying to get me to wear a hat.
A hat.
I don't know.
I feel like she'll look great.
I think I'm already so tall. If I'm wearing a hat, I'm going to take up like the whole space.
I mean, I'm not asking you to wear like a Kentucky Derby hat.
Oh, I love a hat.
A normal hat.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Well, thank you ladies for coming.
Thanks for having us.
We might have to do giveaways for our new Christmas giveaway.
Yeah, I know.
For sure.
It'd be so fun.
Great.
It was so nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you both.
Yes. Yep. And obviously I'll talk to you.
Every day.
Yes. Yeah. But seriously, everyone support them. They are wonderful, wonderful people. And I love what you're doing.
You. Support our sponsors.
Yes, we would like to thank Amanda McCall,
yes,
our sponsor. She's been with us since the beginning now.
She's OG, yeah.
Yeah, she is. She's amazing. Great lender. Also, Wilson Associates Real Estate. It is slowing down a little.
I think it's just because school started. I think everyone goes, let me get the kids in school, and then it's going to pick right back up.
Yeah, I'm actually showing a house right after this, and it's been on the market for like 4 days.
Ooh, wow. I wonder what's wrong with it. It's been on the market for that long.
Nothing. I went there on Sunday.
I'm just being sarcastic.
No, but it's weird. It's different.
Yeah, it's freakish.
We also want to thank Parham Smith, Archenhold, and Blackacre Law. They are my preferred closing attorney. They're wonderful. So thank you, everybody, for your support, and we look forward to seeing you next time.